Okay, we have completed oxides and carbon dioxides. We have completed oxides and carbon dioxides, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide. Now we are going to study another class of compounds of the carbon. Okay, so this binary compounds. Binary compound means only two element must be there. Binary compounds of carbon are called as a carbides. Okay, so that means one element will be carbon, another element can be anything. Is it understood? And the depending on the type of bond, depending on the type of bond between the carbon, depending on the type of bond between the carbon and other element, they are classified into three types. What is the first type? Ionic carbide. What is the first type? Ionic carbide. Okay. Second one is covalent carbide. Third one is interstitial carbide. If it is of ionic bond, the alkali metals, alkan earth metals are highly reactive metals of 13th group, then they can form the ionic bond with the carbon. Okay. So such type of carbides are called as a ionic carbide. The name itself suggests that there will be a ionic bond between the metal and carbon, or element and carbon. Therefore, they are also called as, what it is written, salt like. Okay, this is S, salt like carbide. Okay, next one is covalent carbide. What is the next one? Covalent. So there will be a covalent bond. Most probably these carbides will be formed between the carbon and non-metals of the P block. Okay. Next, interstitial carbide. Just there will be a van der Waal force of attraction, and these are also metals. But these are S block metals and P block metals, but these carbides are formed by the transition metals. Okay. Now the ionic carbides are further divided into three types, but this classification is based upon the hydrolysis product. Okay. The ionic carbide which on hydrolysis produce methane, then they are called as a methanide, methanides, methanide. Okay. Next one, the carbide which produces acetylene, C triple bond C. Okay. What will be the product? Here it is only carbon or methane. Okay. Here on hydrolysis, what will get? Methane as one of the product. Here what will get? CH, triple bond CH as one of the product. Propylide means CH3C triple bond CH. Okay. So any carbide which produces methane are called methanide, acetylene are called acetylide, propyl are called as a propylides. Okay, so is that okay now? Now examples I will give you, you have to remember them. Understood? And most of them already we have covered individually, group wise. Like when we studied the second A, that is argon earth metal group, we have studied that beryllium carbide, Be2C, is a methanide. And when we studied the 13th group, we have studied Al4C3, that is aluminium carbides are example of methanides. Okay. Next, acetylides. Acetylides are two examples, magnesium carbide, MgC2. Okay. And calcium carbide, very, very important example. This I have covered extensively because so many times this question came. Number of sigma bond, number of pi bonds in CaC2. Okay. Then apart from this, there can be another carbide, that is BaC2. These are the examples of acetylides. Acetylides are C2 negative, CH triple bond CH, they will produce. Suppose if I hydrolyze MgC2, one of two reactions, I will write it separately. Okay. Next, allylides. allylides will be C3-4 negative. What is the next one? C3-4 negative. Propylides. Otherwise, we can say allyl means double, triple bond carbon. Next carbon is called as a allylides. Okay. Here Mg2C3, magnesium carbide. MgC2 is acetylide, but another carbide also fall possible by the magnesium. They are Mg2C3. Mg2C3 is a allylide example. Okay. So this will have C3-4 negative. Is it understood? Note down this. Then we will write the reactions of hydrolysis product of these ionic carbides. Okay, write down ionic carbides hydrolysis. Beryllium carbide is methanides because it is giving methane. And now I am going to tell you some true fact. Okay, what that true fact was already once examination question. It was MCET examination question. Al4C3 plus, that I will cover now. Okay, so 12H2O. 12H2O will give you again methane. Magnesium, if it is MgC2, it is giving acetylene, but Mg2C3, it is giving propylide. Okay, so note down this. Then I will tell you some interesting fact which was earlier asked in the MCET. Okay, see, people have wrong tendency and opted this as a AcU2C2, Ag2C2. What they thought, C2 plus H2 will give you CH triple bond CH acetylide, but they have similar structure, but they do not undergo hydrolysis due to the less metallic nature. Copper is less metallic, silver is less metallic. Therefore, on hydrolysis, they do not give acetylenes. Hence, they do not hydrolyze, or they are not considered as a true carbides. True carbides are the ones which on hydrolysis gives either methane or acetylides or propylides on hydrolysis. Okay. Reason, is it understood? Because once it was a MCET question, but in-depth question can be in the mains, in-depth question can be even in the advanced examination. So true carbides, you must know what is the condition. Okay, covalent carbides. These are the compounds of carbon with elements having slightly less electronegativity than it. That means carbon and its nearly same electronegative element. When they combine together to form a binary compound, such as SiC, silicon and carbon electronegativity almost same or nearly same. So B4C, that is boron and carbon. Okay. So these are the carbides which have covalent bond. So that's why they are called as a covalent carbides. Now interstitial carbides will be with the carbon and elements of dash. What are the elements? With which elements they form interstitial carbides? Okay, next and third one and last one is interstitial carbide. Interstitial carbides are formed by the carbon with transition. Simple, S block and highly reactive P block metal will form ionic hydride, and P block non-metal will form covalent carbides, and transition metal and inner transition metal forms interstitial carbides. Okay. And frankly speaking, there is no chemical bond between them. Okay. How they form, just like suppose titanium. So titanium is a closely packed like this. Titanium, what they will do? Closely packing like this. Now, after closely packing also, still there is some small space. Okay. That small space is called as an interstitial void. Void means, is it understood? The space which we cannot avoid, you do any damn thing, you cannot place any atom. But carbon being small atom, it can be trapped here. Now that in between, you can find carbon atom. Okay. So carbon atom is trapped between the metal packing. Okay. That is called as an interstitial. Interstitial means the space between the two lattice points. Okay. So then because of this, the strength will increase. Now the earlier that was empty, now that is also now full. Therefore, it will be extremely hard. But still, it is metal only. Therefore, it is electrical conductor. What it is? It is electrical conductor. Okay. So these are the transition metal. Example: titanium carbide, tungsten carbide, zirconium carbide, vanadium carbide, iron carbide is called cementite. Okay. Note down this. Okay, we have studied the basic definition of carbide. After that, classification. In this topic, preparation is not much important, but classification is very important. Okay, you should be able to identify. Question will be in the integer type question or in more than one correct or single correct option. How many of the following are methanides? How many of the following number of moles of methane produced on hydrolysis of number of moles of acetylene produced on hydrolysis of, like that question will be there. So it is a easy questioning topic. Questions can be framed very easily. Therefore, chances of giving questions on this are more. Okay. So now preparation. Preparation is very simple. That's why it is not important, because they are prepared by heating the either element or its oxide with the carbon at very high temperature. Suppose we wanted to prepare silicon carbide. We can prepare by the element with carbon or oxide with carbon. Okay. So silicon oxide with carbon also gives silicon carbide. Silicon plus carbon also gives silicon carbide. Same way, calcium oxide plus carbon gives calcium carbide. Aluminum plus carbon. See, element with carbon, oxide with carbon, oxide with carbon, element with carbon. Likewise, on heating with the given metal or metal oxide, automatically you are going to get a transition metal, carbide. Okay. These are the only two preparation method, and not much difficult, very easy. Okay. But one funny question, which is most of the students made, is number of oxygen connected to silicon in SiO2. You can also try and give me the answer. Number of oxygen connected to silicon in silicon dioxide. Number of oxygen connected to silicon in silicon dioxide. Okay. Okay, this is what the maximum number of students made a mistake, like you people done. Okay. In SiO2, as I told you, it is a funny mistake. So some people thought that it will not be 2. Then why this question can be direct in IIT? Okay. So somebody said 1, somebody said 2, but answer is magically 4. Okay. What is answer? Magically 4. You may think that why it is written SiO2. It is because, see, each silicon is attached to 4 oxygen. Very important question, very tricky question. Okay. So, but I am writing SiO2. Why not SiO4? Because this is connected to one more silicon. Okay. This is connected to one more silicon. This is connected to one more silicon. This is connected to one more silicon. So half of this belongs to this. Half of belongs to this. Half of belongs to this. Half of belongs to this. So one silicon connected to 4 oxygen, but originally 4 × 1/2, that is 2, SiO2. Is it understood? So this is SiO2 is a network solid. SiO2 is a network solid. Okay. It will keep on spread. See, this will combine with the 4 oxygens. Okay. So same way, this oxygen will combine with one more silicon. This oxygen with 4 oxygens. Okay. So this will keep on spreading. Understood? Actually, this is not planar. It will be tetrahedral. Okay. So only to explain you easily, I have written like this structure, but actual structure will be what? Tetrahedral. What is the structure? Tetrahedral. That also I will draw if you note this one. Okay. Number of oxygen connected to each silicon in SiO2 is 4. Why it is 4? And why the formula is SiO2, is it clear now? So that is the difference between reading from books and attending the video lecture with the experience of the previous exam questions and the mistakes made by your seniors. Okay, this is the SiO2, one block of the SiO2 structure. This will also be silicate. We will study silicate. That also will have the same. Understood? So this oxygen will be attached to one more silicon, which will be center of a tetrahedron. I have shown you only one block. Okay, one unit of SiO2. Is it clear? Note down this structure of SiO2, one unit. And previous structure was to explain why each silicon is connected to four oxygens. Okay, these are some more examples of preparation. Beryllium carbide BeO plus 3C gives Be2C. Same way magnesium carbide, same, there is one thing, MgC2, already I told you it is propylide, like Mg2C3 allylide. But if it is MgC2 acetylide, okay, they are interchangeable. First it will form magnesium carbide. On heating, it will form Mg2C3. Then uses are very important. Only thing you should remember from this topic are first classification on hydrolysis product, then second are uses. Like CaC2, on hydrolysis what it will give? Acetylene. Oxyacetylene torch. You will find, you will study this in detail in the alkynes. Okay, in hydrocarbons, there is a chapter alkynes. So alkynes, that is CH triple bond CH, have the high heat capability. Therefore, that heat released can be used for welding. That procedure is called as a oxyacetylene torch. Okay, this is first use, and some more uses are also going to come, which are very interesting, which are very important. So stay tuned. Okay, uses. Second use is silicon carbide. Commercially very important name, carborundum. After the diamond, the hardest compound, very hard. Therefore, it is used as a abrasive. Abrasive means the substance which is used to sharpen the tools. Okay, so that stone we use for the sharpening of the scissor and etc. knife, they are called as abrasive. Okay, next, tungsten carbide. What is the formula of tungsten carbide? What is the symbol of tungsten? Tungsten carbide, symbol of tungsten. Very good. Tungsten carbide will be WC. WC is not World Cup, it is tungsten carbide. Okay, so it is used in the polishing. Okay, and drilling bits, cutting tools, they are all made up of the tungsten carbide. And B4C is even harder than the silicon carbide. Now it is increasingly brought into use. Earlier people were not knowing about this. The cheap tungsten also better, but it is costlier. So B4C is a hard compound like silicon carbide. Therefore, it can also be used as abrasive and also used to shield for the radioactive radiation. And next, used as a bulletproof vest, bulletproof jackets, bulletproof bunions. Okay. Okay, next topic is halides of carbon. Carbon halides are further divided into two types. What are those two types? Simple halides and mixed halides. Simple halide means they will contain only one type of halogen, like CF4, only fluorine, CCl4, only chlorine, only bromine, only iodine. And among them, thermal stability decreases with increasing size of the halogen. Why? Because halogen size increases, bond length increases, bond energy decreases, therefore it becomes easy to break the bond. Okay, next is stability. After that, sorry, example of the mixed halides are CFCl3, CF2Cl2, very important, freon. What it is called as? Freon, okay? Chlorofluorocarbons. These are called as a chlorofluorocarbons. You will study again in the environmental chemistry. They are the polluting agent. They cause the depletion in ozone layer, okay? CCl3, CClF3, etc. Now, one simple example I'm taking, CF4. If you wanted to prepare, simply you can exchange the oxygen of the carbon from the carbon dioxide with the fluorine, double displacement reaction. This fluorine will displace the oxygen and oxygen will displace the fluorine. Okay. Same way, carbon, silicon carbide plus fluorine. Fluorine will be replaced with added to the silicon also, as well as carbon also. Next, CF2Cl2, this is freon, this is a mixed halide, okay? When it is heated with fluorine, it will be completely converted into CF4 because of the more reactivity of fluorine with respect to the carbon. Okay, preparation of halides of carbon. Next is the carbon tetrachloride. So short form, they will give CTC. What is CTC? Carbon tetrachloride. And its commercial name is pyrene, P-Y-R-E-N-E. So CS2 plus 3Cl2 in presence of ferric chloride at 303 Kelvin, it will give CCl4, and S2Cl2 structure is very, very important. Okay. Next, freon. Freon is CF2Cl2, SbCl5. This is very, very important role. It is a chlorinating agent. SbF3 will give you CCl2F2. Okay? Note down fast. Okay, property. All are covalent and they are electron precise. Electron precise. What is electron precise? If the central atom have exactly 8 electron without any lone pair, then they are called as a electron precise. Okay. So they are covalent because they are electron precise, and they are tetrahedral because of the sp3 hybridization without any lone pair. They are highly inert and non-inflammable. Even they cannot catch fire. So every property got some use. Now, very, very important. Okay. So here in the chemistry, size also matters. Okay. So one previous student, one problem happened with student. If I write this COCl2, what is the difference between, you make out any difference? Here COCl2 is carbonyl chloride. Very good. It is phosgene. It is cobalt chloride. So very, very, chemistry appeared to be very fancy and very easy. The problem is that if you are fascinated with the fanciness of the chemistry, you will get negative marks. Okay. So cobalt chloride is different. COCl2 is also phosgene and it is a poisonous gas. Okay. So COCl2 plus 2HCl. Now this is formed when CCl4 is heated with superheated steam. Already steam you will get when high temperature is maintained. Further, if you heat, then you will get superheated steam. Okay. Now, applications. CCl4 is used as an organic solvent. In organic, you will find aprotic, polar, non-polar, protic solvent. Like that, you will understand. This is a non-polar aprotic solvent. Okay. Then fire extinguisher under the name of pyrene. So if you go for the fire extinguisher, they will say it is pyrene. Pyrene is nothing but CCl4 only. It is because of the highly inert and non-inflammable nature, it is used to extinguish the fire. And anti-hook worm it is used in the medicines. And mixed halides. What is this? Mixed halides. That is what I said. CFC, chlorofluorocarbons, used as a coolant, used as a refrigerant. Is that understood?